Aloha, everyone. My name is Cap, and I am a developer marketing manager at sanity.io. And today for our talk, I have Grant with me. Grant, would you like to introduce yourself?
Yeah, hi, I'm Grant. I'm VP of engineering at Formidable.
Awesome. So today we're going to talk about sanity.io and the Next Sanity package, and also about the introduction of the app router with Next.js. So adopting the app router requires a bit of a mind shift. And today, Grant and I will be talking about using the app router and how it's impacted his business. They use Next.js and Sanity for a lot of their clients, so they're in the mix of things. So Grant, first question I have is, you're in the process of switching a lot of your current apps to app router. What would you say is the biggest quality of life benefit you've seen?
Yeah, I think two things would be server components and being able to fetch data just from within any given component allows us to co-locate our data fetching in low-level components, and nested layouts where we can just nest layouts by just dropping in a file, also managing error and loading states within those nested layouts using just error and loading files.
So you've been migrating a lot from Next 12 to Next 13. Were there any hiccups you saw that you had to figure out, and how did you solve it?
Yeah, so early on, many libraries in the open source space just weren't quite compatible with React server components. So libraries that would work in Next 12 in the normal pages router just wouldn't quite work in Next 13 with the app router. So there is sort of a tricky migration path there. So a big one would be like styled components was one where you would have to wrap all of your styled components into these client components and sort of opt out of React server components. So there's some moving around that you would have to do to get that to work. Nowadays, a lot of the ecosystem has caught up. So a lot of these issues that we experienced early on are no longer as big of issues. There seems to be a lot better support across the ecosystem.
Hey, that's good to hear. So developers can now embed the Sanity Studio directly into their Next.js app using the Next Sanity package. So how has having the studio and your application's code live in one place under the app router been better for your developers and clients?
Yeah, so previously we were often seeing people deploy a separate code for their Sanity Studio and for their front-end Next application. So oftentimes they would live in totally separate repos. So you're managing two separate repositories. It was hard to share code, and then you'd have separate build tooling, separate deployment processes, and then your content authors would have to go to different URLs to manage content versus like where the public site would be. So there was sort of a disjointment there that was sort of not great for both developers and for content editors. So being able to embed the Sanity Studio helps quite a bit. It alleviates pretty much all of those pain points. You can manage just the Next.js application, use its build pipeline, use just one single deployment process, and then you're just deployed on a single domain. So your editors can just go visit like slash studio or whatever you want your URL to be for your Sanity Studio. Mm-hmm. I'd love to pop up in my code editor and show how simple it is to actually set this up. So with App Router, I have a page. This is just a standard page in App Router. I'm just returning a studio component out of this. And in my studio component, it's a client component because we're going to have some client-side code that Sanity Studio is going to need to run. But there's actually a Next Studio component that Next Sanity exports. That makes it dead simple. You just drop this thing right in here, and we've got about, five lines of code effectively to basically plop your Sanity Studio into a subroute of your Next.js application. So very little code to get this up and running in a Next.js app. And then you can just deploy this along with the rest of your Next application.
Yeah, I remember when we launched this, I was like, wait, there's got to be more. There has to be more work that I have to do.
Yeah, absolutely. And actually, line 10 is an extra piece that isn't really needed. This is just specific to this project. So really, you could probably cut out another 5 lines of code from this. Very, very pretty simple.
Right on. Yeah, it's very simple. It's very just like, here's a couple of lines. The Sanity engineers have taken care of all the hard work. So yeah, I'm glad that we have that now as a feature and that we can embed it. Because having the studio live at the main URL has got to be super convenient for editors. It's now just yourwebsite.com/studio or /admin or whatever you'd like that path to be named. All right, so my next question is, how are you using Next.js revalidate tag with Sanity, and what main benefits have you seen? Could you actually show us an example of caching and revalidation between Sanity and Next that you have in a project?
Yeah, I'll show a little diagram here that shows how I think about this at a high level. So let's say we have a web page. It's got a header, a body, and a footer, each of which makes its own sanity request to get data. And it tags each of those requests with like a deterministic tag to use for caching purposes. So this is using the server components and co-locating our data fetches. So that's all fine and dandy, but things get a little more interesting once we put this caching piece into this. So let's say we have a client, a visitor to our web page that requests the web page. It hits our Next.js server, and we're going to make those three fetch requests. It could be three, it could be one, it could be 20 requests. But each request is, before it goes to sanity, we'll actually make a little stop at the fetch cache to see if there's cached data for the given tag that has been provided for that fetch. And if it does, you just get cached data back for that request. Otherwise, it's going to go to sanity, it's going to get the data, and it's going to populate that cache for that given tag and then return that data back. After the first request, the second visitor to this page is just going to get all cached data for all three requests or all 20 requests. And so it allows you to, you know, cache at the individual request layer there. So this is all fine and dandy, but there's this situation that should be happening regularly where you have content authors who want to change data and they want to see their content updates on the website. Like if those content changes never show up, then somebody's going to be angry.
Yeah.
So we've got to talk a little bit about on-demand invalidation. So we've got our content editor in the Sanity Studio, and they make content changes, which goes to the Sanity Content Lake, and you can configure a webhook to fire off a request, a post request to your app server whenever content changes in your project. So you can set up a Next.js API route that receives that webhook with some information about what content changed. And you do a little bit of logic to map the information about the content change into a cache tag that you had used previously to get that content. And then you invalidate that cache tag in the fetch cache by using Next.js's revalidate tag function. So that's sort of like at a high level how I think about the caching and how you invalidate stuff when content changes. So we'll pop open a little code just to see what that looks like in practice and how the next sanity library actually abstracts over a lot of the hard parts of that. So I have a little helper function in this project. We're using this create client function from the next sanity library to create a fetch client. And I just have a little helper function that takes in some details and some tags, some cache tags. And then it just uses this sanity client and passes through the tags into our Next.js fetch cache options that's made available by Next Sanity. So this is a way we can basically pass through our cache tags and let the client basically tag our fetch requests. So if we go look at a usage of this, I have a get post data function that is fetching blog post data. And we've got a query and we're passing through some tags. Basically what I'm doing is using a helper here that takes the blog post slug and then generates out a cache tag for the blog post with that slug. So that's good. Now we've got the tagging of our requests done, but we still have to handle the API route for webhook handling to invalidate our cache. So I have an API route, it's a post request, and the Next Sanity library exports this parse body function that makes it really easy to basically determine whether or not it's a valid payload and then give you the information about the changed content. So it handles the security for you. All you have to do is set up a secret that's shared between Sanity and your Next app. And then you can check for, you know, whether or not it's a valid payload. I've got a lot of logic in here. I'm going to skip over most of it, but this one is basically looking to see, okay, given the content change, what is the cache tag that we need to invalidate? We're going to add that to our list of tags to invalidate. And you can add whatever sort of app logic you need around caching. But once you've collected up some tags to invalidate, you can just loop through your cache tags that you want to invalidate and run this revalidate tag function exported from Next.js.
Awesome. Awesome walkthrough. And those diagrams, they helped a lot. It's been awesome to see how Formidable is using the app router and Sanity for their apps. Thanks for allowing me to pick your brain on this hot topic. It seems Formidable is finding a lot of success with the app router. Do you have any final thoughts?
Yeah, it's been great. The upgrade to App Router might be a little rocky at first, but we definitely feel it's a step in the right direction for the ecosystem as a whole.
Right on. Thanks for joining me, Grant. Thanks, everyone, for watching our talk, and we will see you around. Thank you.